Hello everyone. Bonjour tout le monde. Double down swimmer. 大家下午好。I hope you can hear me very well, even though you couldn't see me very well. Oh, I'm so sorry, I'm too small. And you can climb the third floor, perhaps. I'm very happy and feel honored to attend this conference. Even though it's not my first time in Dubrovnik, but it's really my first time to stand here in so beautiful and amazing hall to meet you, to talk with you, and to share the experience with you, especially to learn a lot of things from you. And first of all, I would like to read a small letter. It's written by our director of Hebei Museum. Because she couldn't come here, I just present the Hebei Museum. Dear friends, Hebei Province has a very special location around Beijing, the capital city of China. Since the 70th anniversary for the founding of the People's Republic of China is going to be held, I will not be able to attend the meeting as scheduled, but I would like to express my sincerest apologies to you. If you come to Beijing, China next time, you can stay one more day for visiting Hebei Museum. I will welcome you here. It's from our director, Luo Xiangjun. Yes, a greeting from her. And I suggest you that you could take a picture as a proof. So one day if you come to China, just show her. And in this picture, we can see two maps. The first one and is precisely show the position of our province. Hebei province. And the right part, it is the right star, and you can see it's our capital, Beijing. So each time when I was asked by some people, where do we come from? Then I will say, I come from China. And he asked me, which part? I will say, in the north, because near Beijing, because I couldn't say that I come from my hometown, the city named Handan, or the province named Hebei. Each time when I say it, the people, I can see some little small confused expression on the face. Then I say myself, don't pretend to know it. I know you don't know it. It's really normally because China is so far away and so huge. We have so many cities and so many provinces. So that's why today I would like to show you, to present you that our province and our province museum. You can see that the position is like the heart of a human being, like the bodies. Yes, it's in China. And the second picture you can see is like a zoomate of the map. The red star is always Beijing, and that the museum, the right part is a museum where it's located. So today, I would like to tell something about the innovation of tradition and the source and how the museum emphasizes on practice and to achieve the great goal. First, I would like to introduce a brief introduce of our Hebei Museum. Hebei Museum is like a provincial and a comprehensive museum. It's a national first-class museum in Hebei province, and it was founded in 1953. In 2006, museum started the reconstruction and the expansion project. And it has expanded the new area, because before is the north part is the old part, and we expanded to the south of the original building. So on 2013, the new buildings were complete and opened for trial operation. And the next year is on 2014, Hebei Museum was officially opened. And in last year is 2018, Hebei Museum has the honor to get the title of the most innovative museum in China. I have a little question, perhaps you can guess it. You know how many museums in China? Somebody would like to guess a number? 1 million, oh, it's too much. I don't know neither, but I can check. I checked this morning in a Google, but in Chinese. Yes, so it says by last year, the May, in China, we have totally 5,400 museums. So yes, it's still allowed. And the most innovative museum in China, yes, it's not the unique, it's not the only one, but still we can award this award among so many thousands museums. It must have some important, amazing things and procedures. So let's go on. Yeah, this you can see is the new part, the north part. And this part, this white and black one is the old part, is the south part, which was founded with, in the 1968, is like 50 years ago. And this is the new part. This was built in 2006. It has three floors and one underground, and the south part's gross floor area is 33,000 square meters, which divided into 11 exhibition halls. So the south part and the north part in together, we have 33,000 square meters, and the exhibition area is over 22,000 square meters. And these two parts are linked together by a sunshine hole. So each time I say that I come from a small city, but you see a small city with a so big museum. In fact, it's not small. it's relatively. So our museum has been committed to making cultural relics come alive. We selected more than 5,000 cultural relics and put them on display in 9 basic exhibitions. The exhibition Treasure of Han Dynasty, the Han Domes in Mancheng Country, won the 12th National Museum Top 10 Exhibition Prize. And the exhibition The Strong Power of the Warring States, the Zhongshan States, it's in some dynasty in our history. It won the 13th National Museum Top 10 Exhibition Prize. So since 2014, our museum has actively explored how to attract the international tourists like you come to music like the visitor for the first time, and the local visitors like me to visit again. So with all the efforts, the numbers of the audience reception has been accelerating year by year. So in 2014, we can wait a moment. This is the project I just mentioned, the 9 basic displays. In fact, this display is divided into 2 parts also. One is a history project and another one is an art project. The history project that concerns all the dynasties and the stories, legends from the history. And the art project, as you see, we have also a lot of folk arts like stone carvings and select porcelains and the frescoes of the northern dynasties. This is just some pictures to show that with the history projects. This one is some like the body is in bronze and the feet is in iron, which covered from the Warring States period. And this one, if you could see in detail, it has 4 phoenix and 4 dragons. It's in bronze. And it's also from 3,000 years ago. And this is a map, very expensive, is in bronze, gold, and silver. It's like some mummy, but in Chinese ways, in Han Dynasty. And this Changxin Palace lamp is our national first class relics. Yeah, so we come back to the population. In 2014, the number of the visitors has only 447,000. And by 2017, the number of the visitors already exceeded 1 million. And we expect that the number of visitors to reach this year, by the end of this year, 2019, 1.5 million. So how the museum do to attract so many visitors and get the prize the most in most innovative last year? So I invite you to just follow me to see. We have five important points. The first one is innovate the concept of curation, express the diversified stories of Hebei Museum. So our temporary exhibition has gradually explored and formed four systems. Which four system? One is a word story, China story, and Hebei story, and nature story. So in the process of constantly practice, which meets the spiritual and cultural requirement of the public in different ages and levels. This you can see it sounds like we tell a good story of word story. It's a painting of Mediterranean, a city of ancient Mediterranean. And this one is we take a city, Paestum in Greece, as an international renewed city. So as a clue, this exhibition selects the last exhibition results in the past 10 years to show the unique civilization formed under the collision and the blending of many ethnic groups in the area of Great Greece. And this is also Mediterranean civilization is from ancient Egypt to Byzantium Empire. This is some introduced relics from the Russia, the Russian Empire treasure about the Peterhof State Museum Reserve. And we also tell about good story about the China story. You know, Dunhuang is in the province of Gansu, is really far away from our province. If you travel really, it can take a few weeks. So how to show the people the real Dunhuang and the relics there, we also introduce a lot of things from there. So make it no longer far away. And this is like calligraphy and the painting is all our traditional things from Dynasty Qing and Ming. And it's the ancient tea house road. Perhaps some of you know that it's very famous, the ancient tea house road. And about the Hebei story, in fact, what's the meaning of Hebei? That you know the Yellow River in China, right? He, that means the river, and Bei, that means in the north of the river. So that means our province is in the north of the Yellow River. Of course, we have also Henan, the south of the Yellow province. So we also tell a lot of stories about our region because we also left rich and amazing, a lot of art and relics from history. For example, this kind of thing we call that Hebei clapper. And the about the natural story, yes, as we mentioned, our museum is a comprehensive museum, not only about the history art, but also about the nature. For example, we cooperate with the Zhejiang Nature Museum to introduce the marine flowers coral exhibition collected. And which one is very interested for the kids is like dinosaurs and specimens of the Chinese animals. And real flying flowers. You could see that a lot of children and kids come to attend these activities. So according to the concept of four stories series, 165 temporary exhibitions have been held since 2013 with an average of 24 per year. The exhibition Xingshan, as you see, this Xingshan contemporary shape of Chinese traditional culture was awarded the 16th National Museum Top 10 Exhibition Promotion Award. This contents about the Xingshan exhibition. So we are holding a series of excellent exhibition in our own province. We also actively promoting our cultural relics for exchange exhibition. For example, we put our relics in the Shanxi Museum. It's just next to our province, our neighbor. And this is the Museum of Chinese Gardens and Landscape Architecture in Beijing. National Museum of China is also in Beijing. We cooperate with them. And Yangzhou Museum in the south of China. This also, we attended the exhibition in Taiwan. The second point, innovate social education brand sharing three-dimensional culture in Hebei Museum. So our museum relies on profound cultural resources and cultural relics, constantly enrich the service content, improve the way the quality and the level of service. At present, we have formed the reality complete public education service system and developed 10 independently educational service brands. For example, this is our happy school. We have developed a 6 measure system covering cultural relics, intangible cultural heritage, traditional culture, aesthetic education, and other topics. So we have 60 kinds of courses until now. Combine the exhibition hall visits, multimedia teaching, interactive games, hand-on production, and forming a series of courses from kindergarten to high school students. This is like some painting course, try to teach the children how to paint a fresco, yes, with the painting skills. And is developing animal elements in cultural relics and teaching them with some funny way. We also combine our traditional festivals, a lot of festivals, and yes, combine it to other museums. This one is something special. Throughout this kind of activities, we promote the rehabilitation training of autistic children. That means they have some kind of problem about the spirit. So through some activities between them, the children and the parents. And the small little actors to present the big stories in the history, something like that. And we also have opera celebrities, youth associations, and the children gathered together read, sing for generations. It's just like some things, activity things. And Happy Craft Workshop is combined the study of cultural relics and the heritage and the production of traditional handicrafts to bring the public three-dimensional cultural experience. And we also have some voluntary teams carry on the traditional cultural benefits the other people. The activities held every year, telling the national treasure story, letting the cultural spread to influence, like the sunshine. Yeah, we have also the lectures, museum lectures, you see. Yeah. So the museum lectures is a public welfare lectures which has been held each Sunday morning. It has become a social education project after more than 5 years. Since the beginning of the lecture in 2014, there have been a total of 227 issues covering different series of topics, such as cultural heritage, cultural relics appreciation, cultural relics protection, music and art, traditional culture, museum direction, introducing exhibits, and tea culture, which is closely related to the lives of people. And at the same time, the issues of the four home were collected to republication of five series. And we also cooperate with the travel agency. Just like yesterday, we also took our work on the old wall. So we launched the Hebei Museum tour, and the project is rooted in the whole province, rich cultural resources, tourism resources, as well as experts into presentation. It's not only a cultural tourism integration project, but also a study tour project. This kind of learning in traveling and traveling in learning improve the quality of tourism and share the cultural value. This what we hold some kind of activities of museum night. And the third point is motivate service mode optimizing all around experience in Hebei Museum. Since the Hebei Museum was opened, the updating and the transformation of all kinds of open facilities and equipment has been continuously promoted. The infrastructure of the North District has been obviously improved, which has created conditions for the reception and high-grade cultural relics exhibitions. For example, this one, the calligraphy and painting house has been transformed to realize the constant humidity. In whole space, strict requirements for the humidity of the exhibition hall can be displayed. The Russian Empire treasure of the Peterhof State get exhibited in this hall. They needed any cover on it. This one, we also created some like the service self-service tickets machine has also been installed to improve the dilemma of waiting tickets. I know that there's no problem for everyone's museum here, but in China it's really a big problem because we have too many population and visitors each day. So to issue this problem is really a big achieve. And large-scale interactive experience, original animation display, high definition, HD, interactive multimedia display provide a multi-angle, motivate to understand the exhibition and the cultural relics information. We have also somebody to remind audience to use this ticket and to go to the north gate, west gate, not the west, the north gate, something like that. Yes, all the measures do. This is the 3HD interactive display. And we have also some lockers, strollers for children, and wheelchairs, drinking water, charging piles, wireless Wi-Fi, and so on. So many facilities provide a comfortable experience for visitors in the museum. The fourth is the innovation, culture, and creative products shaping substantive Hebei Museum memories. So we pass really fast. That means that we created also a lot of creative products relying on the museum, the cultural creative protected stores, and we also earned a lot of awards. This is something practical for using. This one. It's in the area from the old part to new part, and you won't miss it. The last one, sorry, innovation propaganda means and spreading multi-dimensional Hebei Museum reputation. That means we cooperate with a lot of metro, bus, airports, and hotels to propaganda. And we use also Weibo and WeChat. Some CCTV programs, series. Okay, for a limit of time, I must stop here. So I'm very happy to share it with you. Next time, I hope that somebody ask me, I can see that my hometown is near Hebei Museum, only 1 hour by train. Thank you.